Dear students, in this video we are going to learn about the sterilization. So very first thing is, now we have understood due to this situation of COVID-19, we have gone through the sterilization or disinfection procedures, or we are finding these procedures nowadays really important because the microorganisms found in the surrounding as well as on the objects all and along on the surface of the human body. So sometimes they cause the contamination, infection and decay. It becomes necessary to remove or destroy the organisms. So this is the basic object of the sterilization. So to remove or to kill the microorganisms is known as the sterilization. The method of sterilization used depends on the purpose for which the method is to be carried out, and along with the method, the material which is to be sterilized, and which are the types of microorganisms which we are going to remove or we are going to kill the type of microorganisms. So here, sterilization is nothing but it is the process by which an article, surface or medium is made free from all living microorganisms either in the vegetative or spore state. Microorganisms which are causing the contamination, infection or decomposition, which has such type of microorganisms, must be removed or destroyed from the material or from the areas. The method of the sterilization is depending upon the purpose and material and nature of the microorganisms. Microorganisms are the object of sterilization. This process of sterilization shows application in microbiology for prevention of contamination by extraneous organism in surgery for maintenance of asepsis, or in food and drug manufacturing. It is also playing an important role because we should not allow the contamination of any type of bacteria, which will not be permitted in such type of cases. So there are some sterilizing agents which will be either bactericidal or they may be bacteriostatics. So we will see some of the basic definitions. So first we have seen is the sterilization, that is, it is nothing but the process by which an article, surface or medium is freed from all living microorganisms which are either present in a vegetative or spore state. Now disinfection. Disinfection is nothing but the destruction of all pathogenic organisms. Asepsis is the state of complete absence of viable pathogenic microorganisms in any environment. Now next is antiseptics. Antiseptics are the agents that can be safely applied on the skin or mucous membrane to prevent the infection by inhibiting the growth of bacteria. So there is a difference between sterilization, disinfection and antiseptics. Next is the bactericidal agent. So bactericide or germicide, that means side, C-I-D-E, it means the killing. So these are the substances that can kill the bacteria, while that of bacteriostatic agents, these are only preventing the multiplication of bacteria, which may or however they may remain alive. A chemical which is bactericidal at a particular concentration, it is bacteriostatic. Then next is the decontamination. It is the process of rendering an article or area free of contaminants including microbial, chemical, radioactive and other hazardous materials from an area, object or body surface. So decontamination is again completely different because it is allowing complete freeness of completely free from the contaminants Then microbial contaminants, it may be including chemical contaminants, radioactive or other hazardous material as well. Along from the area, object or body surface, so completely freeness from all type of surfaces, this will be called as decontamination. So there is a difference between sterilization and disinfection. So here we can see that sterilization involves the method used that can kill all microorganisms and spore. Here it is the method used which can kill most of microorganisms but not the spores. So sterilization, disinfection, these are two different techniques. Although it sounds similar that we are supposed to eradicate the microorganisms, but in sterilization we obtain the complete killing, that is spores are also killed, where in disinfection the spores remain there. Then it is a better method. Sterilization is used when we are dealing with the drugs or dosage form, or we are supposed to undergo surgery. Then it is not that much good because it is not ensuring 100% free from bacteria, that is 99%. So 0.1% remains, that is disinfection. Here sterilization can be done by using autoclave, use of chemicals like aldehyde or gases like ethylene oxide. Here example that we are disinfecting the floor with the help of Dettol, alcohol, or sometime we are having the disinfection of the baby water bottles or milk bottles by boiling or by having the pasteurization of the milk. So we are having the disinfection of these particular surfaces or the objects. So the sterilization basically is classified depending upon the methods of sterilization. We can have the classification as thermal, non-thermal. When if we are involving the temperature for the sterilization, then that techniques or that these methods will be called as thermal method, which will be involving use of hot air oven, autoclave, and other method where we are not going to use the temperature, these will be called as non-thermal. So here we will have the gaseous sterilization, radiation sterilization. So first instrument used is the hot air oven. This is the image of hot air oven. Here dry heat is used for sterilization purpose. Dry heat is having the lethal effects due to the large oxidation process. This large oxidation process will be having the killing effect on the microorganisms. The dry heat is also able to do the protein denaturation, oxidative damage and toxic effects of the electrolyte, and this will be requiring the higher temperature, that is it will be from 140 to 180 degrees Celsius, and we have to maintain this temperature up to 2 hours so that we can obtain the complete killing of the microorganisms. Its application is restricted to the glassware, metals, surgical instrument, thermostable powders, etc. Because those who are heat sensitive, these materials cannot be sterilized by use of hot air oven. Major industrial application is in the sterilization of the glass bottles, or where we are having the aseptic feeling. At this point, this technique will be used of dry heat, and it adequates the sterility assurance levels, but it also destroys the bacterial endotoxins. Bacterial endotoxins are products of gram-negative bacteria, and they are called as pyrogens. These pyrogens are responsible to cause the fever when injected into the body. So for the depyrogenation of the glasses, temperature is kept around 150 degrees Celsius. So for this purpose, the article which will be used for the sterilization is the dry heat will be carried out over the article. Here one we can go for the flaming process. First is the flames that we are doing in the microbiology practicals. The inoculating loops or wires or the forceps points, these will be held in the Bunsen flame, that is blue flame of the gas flame. In that they will be kept till they become red hot. So the point at which they becomes red hot, this indicates that these wire loops or the whole forceps is sterilized by help of dry heat. Now if we want the sterilization of scalpels, needles, mouths of the culture tube, glass slides, cover slip, these can be passed from through that flame for few minutes. So this will be allowing the sterilization of that glass slides, the needles or the culture tube mouth, that can be sterilized. The Bunsen flame without allowing them to become red hot. Here no red hot condition we have to obtain, because the glass may melt at that temperature. We have to just pass it through the Bunsen flame so that it becomes sterilized. Now this sterilization instrument, hot air oven, it is made up of stainless steel. Inside the material is stainless steel, and then they are having a chamber. This full chamber is having the capacity of 250 liters, and inside this stainless steel chamber there are the heaters. Depending upon the capacity, the heater coils will be either two side or three side, or depending upon the capacity there may be use of the thermocouples to monitor the temperature of both the oven air as well as the article present. And there will be a fan which will be providing the circulation of the air so that rapid equilibration of the temperature can be maintained. A fixed temperature sensor, this is the thermometer or sometime temperature sensor will be there, which will be indicating what is the exact temperature inside it. And door locking controls will be provided so that interruption will not be there for the sterilization cycle. Once you put it off, this door is closed. Once the door is closed, you cannot open if it is kept for a fixed period, that is fixed period of 1 hour suppose, and having temperature of 120 degrees Celsius. So after 1 hour only the door will be opened. So like settings will be there in hot air oven. So whichever article is to be sterilized in hot air oven, that article will be wrapped. This article will be wrapped with the help of a paper of a container of sufficient strength and integrity. So it will be good to have the sterilization, and it will be also having the protection against the contamination. Depending upon the container shape and design, the paper should be taken, and accordingly the heat penetration is maintained. For example, syringe. If syringe is taken, then the covering of that syringe will be done in the same way, so that after sterilization also it cannot be get contaminated due to the contamination from the environment or by touching of the people who are going to handle that syringe. So the material should be of such manner that it should be allowing the free circulation of the air in between the glassware, and the glassware should be perfectly dry before we are going to put into the oven. At 180 degrees Celsius, cotton wool plug may be charred. So if we are going to put cotton wool, then we cannot maintain the temperature up to 180 degrees Celsius. So this will be about hot air oven. Next is the autoclave. Autoclave will be having the use of moist heat. Now in hot air oven we have seen is the dry heat. Now here moist heat will be occurring. The simple example of autoclave is the pressure cooker at our home. So moist heat will be applied for processing
of many thermostable products. Those who are not stable for dry heat, they can be sterilized by having moist heat. In pharmaceutical and medical sectors, it is used for sterilization of the dressing sheets, surgical and diagnostic equipments, containers, and aqueous injections. Sometimes the ophthalmic preparation, irrigation fluids, and some of the solids undergoing the processing, these will be also sterilized by using moist heat. It actually involves the simple type of autoclaves and large scale autoclaves also. Here we will be observing only the simple laboratory use autoclave, or pressure cooker can be used as for the autoclaving purpose. Here the temperature maintained in the range of 121 to 134 degrees Celsius. Temperature can be elevated in moist heat sterilization method because here there is a generation of steam which is having pressure over it. So that due to that pressure, moist heat is able to have the sterilization. Sterilization of bottle fluids and porous material can be done. For example, surgical dressings. Then for surgical dressing, if we are supposed to have the sterilization, then we have to go for 121 degrees Celsius for 15 minutes or at 134 degrees Celsius for 3 minutes respectively. To act as an efficient sterilizing agent, steam should be able to provide the moisture and heat efficiency to the article. The principle of the autoclave or steam sterilizer is that when the water boils, here at the bottom there is a water, it gets boiled and steam is produced. So depending upon that water, there will be creation of vapor pressure. This vapor pressure will be equal to the surrounding temperature or atmosphere. So depending upon this, the steam sterilizers are classified into different types. That is laboratory autoclaves, hospital dressing sterilizer, bowl and instrument sterilizer, rapid cooling sterilizer. Major industrial and hospital sterilizer are usually supplied with dry saturated steam, and attention is paid to removal of water droplets within the supply to prevent the introduction of the water fog into the sterilizer. Now this is the portable autoclave, or we can say portable sterilizer. Autoclave is nothing but a stainless steel vessel designed to withstand steam pressure employed in the sterilization. The portable sterilizer is having electric heater to produce the steam and are used for small pilot or laboratory scale sterilization and for the treatment of instrument and utensils. The autoclave can be used. The large scale sterilizer we will see in the next video. Thank you.